We all like animation in mobile apps, and why not? It becomes even better when you have guided animation, which helps your user to understand the flow. Today, we'll create a 3D flip payment animation like this. Hello and welcome back. My name is Afzal and you're watching channel CodeX. Let's jump into the tutorial and create some basic layout for card input. Just a reminder, if you have missed part one of this 3D flip animation, visit the link in the description or click on the card above. Okay, here we are creating input fields for card number, name, expiry date and CVV input. You can always slow down or pause the video if you want to go through the code. Nothing fancy, just a normal decoration stuff. We are providing a card number, name on the card, expiry date and CVV number. And our UI part is ready. Now, let's create a variable for card number and pass this information to front view of the card. Here in the card widget, we'll have to create one field which will hold coming information. In our front view, let's remove the hard-coded number and we'll replace it with the card number. Now you can see the card goes blank because we haven't provided any data yet. So now let's do some formatting on this card number and convert it to a 16-digit number. We'll do it by padding the number. We can use padding right with the asterisk marks and we'll replace the binding from card number to formatted card number. Let's do some alignment work to make the card number appear from the left, and for that we'll have to customize some property and it looks perfect. Next thing which we have to do is put the spaces after each four character. We'll do it by using regular expression, and you can stop and copy the regular expression or you can follow the link for GitHub to copy paste exactly the same. Basically, what we are doing for each group match of four, we are adding a space, and that's pretty simple, right? And now we have this nice four groups of four digit numbers. Before I proceed, I want to thank my subscribers and viewers, and I will request you to subscribe if you haven't already. I got few suggestions on this card flip demo to make it as a component, and you guys can put your suggestion and request in the comment below. Without delaying, let's get back to tutorial and populate our card with user input. For that, we need text edit controller. We'll initialize this in the constructor and we'll use as a controller in text field. Now, whenever there's a change in this controller, what we have to do is repopulate the value of our variable new data and we'll set the state so that our UI get refreshed. Now let's hot reload and see how it looks. Perfect. We are getting the user input. Let's add a monotype font. I have used Google's Roboto font. I'll put the link in description. And why we need this? Because we don't want each character to be of a different width. Because in the 16 numbers, they should be of the same width, even if it's 1, 2, 8 or asterisk, it has to be of the same width. So now after adding font, let's modify our front view and we'll use a family of robot. And now if I decrease the size, let's see. Okay, all the numbers are of same width and this looks perfect. Let's give max length property of 16 and we are good to go. For CVV input, again we are going to use TextEdit controller and the process will be same. We'll declare it and initialize it in the constructor. Once initialized, we'll add a listener and whenever the text changes, we have to update the CVV value and we'll set the state as previous. Now this time, the CVV number we have to pass to the card back. Let's create a field and constructor as we have done for card number. and this number will be directly passing to the CVV. We'll be passing this value from our main page, and we'll get this value with the help of controller, which we have attached to text field of CVV. So we are in the last part of our tutorial, where we'll create animation, and for this we'll use animation controller and double animation. I have another video for animation which you can check on the card here above, and I'll put the link also in description. So we'll be initializing these values in init state for animation controller and animation, and we'll provide this value inside our transform. Instead of rotating manually, we'll provide this animation. Now the most important part, we have to use a focus node to detect the focus of CVV, and our animation will be triggered on focus and defocus. We'll write a listener on CVV focus, and we'll detect if whether it has a focus or not. If it has focus, then we have to show the back side of the card, and if it doesn't have, it will be a front side. And for that, we'll use a forward and reverse animation of animation controller. Let's attach focus node to our CVV text field, and we are almost done. The only thing we have to do is check whether our animation is working or not. We'll set the state, and at initialize time we'll say that move the animation forward, and it's working. And so let's see the entire animation, and we'll write some number, we'll put some CVV, and it's working as expected. Thank you guys for watching. I'll request you to subscribe if you haven't already. Do like the video, put your comments, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching.